Moving right along here, this is video number three for data science building blocks. Again, I'm Joe. If you've been following along, go ahead and open up your data science building blocks one Excel worksheet. If you haven't been following along and you just want to learn how to remove duplicates and how to use the average if function, just go down to the time that you see on the bottom of the screen. However, I highly recommend you go back and watch videos one and two, because we're only three videos in. Just so that you can get to this point with the rest of us. So let's start by going to the Data Table tab, unfilter if you haven't already by clicking this, clear filter, and let's select everything in column A by starting in cell A2, Control Shift down, and we'll do a copy. Then we'll go to our Pivot Table tab, go ahead and copy the values in cell D4. So right click, copy values is this one here. If you paste, it will paste everything. The format, the formulas, the values. You can just do formulas, you can just do formatting. Let's just do values for now. If I right click again and do formatting just to show you, it now looks like it does in the table, right? We've got the underline border here matching what we have in the table, but I'm gonna back arrow out. I just want to see the values, and I'm doing this on the pivot table tab just so we can do a side by side with our pivot table, which I would recommend doing this with the pivot table, but this is just to show you one, how to remove duplicates, and two, how to use the average if formula. So everything's selected already, don't need to do that. Go to the data tab and click this icon here to remove duplicates. You want to do this in column D, select okay, and here you have 15 unique values remain. Pivot table has already grouped these, so we can see that it's right just by comparing it to the pivot table. It's not in order, however, so I'll just select this area here, do a filter, and sort A to Z, just to put it in order. Double click the edge here to expand it, and now I'll do the average ifs formula, or average if formula in this case. So all formulas start with an equal sign, equals average if. I just moved it down with my down arrow and then did a tab to select the formula. I could have also double clicked. It gives you some direction here after you click it. So range is what you want. We'll go back to the data table. Entity is our range. This is where we want to do the lookup. So if I just select entity, the formula is smart enough to know that I'm selecting the entire column from the table. Do a comma right after that. Only because if you don't do a comma and you navigate away, your formula will change and it will get thrown off. So just do a comma before you move over back to the tab and then start the next argument. So it put a pivot table there because it moved you to the pivot table tab. You're doing the formula on the sheet, so you can either leave that there exactly how it is or backspace it out. It doesn't actually matter. Your criteria is what you want to look up. So in this case, Australia. When we do the formula in cell E5, then we'll want to grab Brazil. That will automatically change as we go down and drag the formula down, unless we have the cells locked. By locking, I mean putting a dollar sign in front of either the column or the row or both. If you do that, and you can do this by clicking F4, you see the dollar signs are there. When I do that, that means column D will never change and row 4 will never change. Therefore, if I just drag this formula down, it will always be looking at Australia. Well, I don't want it to do that. I'm going to drag it down and I want it to look at Brazil. So column D is fine. We're never going to leave column D, but we are going to move from row 4 to 5 to 6, so we don't want that dollar sign in front of the 4 to lock it. So I clicked F4 two more times. You can also manually type in the dollar sign. Best practice here would be to lock column D, because if we wanted to look up something else, we would still want this to be our lookup. We're never going to leave column D, so go ahead and lock it with a dollar sign. I'll do another column, and this is where I actually want to do the calculation. What's the average of Australia? So comma, back to data table. Now I want to select this row, because here, this is where we actually look up the life expectancy. And just the formula, because we have average here, we'll look up the average of this column. So that's good to go. We don't need to lock these ranges because the formula is smart enough to know that we're doing this off of a table and it's grabbing the whole column. So this is the end. We've given it everything that we need. Go ahead and close it with a close parenthesis, and then click enter. So there you have it. It's 54.29. Just go ahead and double click the square. Now it will move all the way down. If I go down to Russia, for example, do an F2 or double click, that allows me to see the formula. So you can see this middle value here didn't leave column D. It wouldn't because we didn't drag it to the right. But just to demonstrate, if I do drag this over to the right, it will still look at Russia. However, it's a divide by zero because we didn't lock the table ranges. Therefore, it will move from left to right on the previous tab. So it went from entity to year and from life expectancy to nothing. Or actually, it went from life expectancy back to entity at the very start of the table. That we don't want. So I'll go ahead and delete that. What I'll actually do now, just so we can see that it's correct, is go to the pivot table and go back down to your values, value field settings, average, and here we have it. I'll select everything here, go back to the home tab, and just for now, move all these decimal points. We can see that we have the same thing. And by the way, the sum ifs equation does the exact same thing. So if we do equals sum if and go ahead and select our range, but we have already done the work. Let's just completely back out of this. Click this cell here. I'll just select this and do a control C to copy. Put it right. I'll double click, put it right in here. We have to do an equals ahead of it, and I'll backspace average out and do sum. So we can see sum if. I just double click that. That's the formula we want. It's the exact same equation. I don't need to change anything else. It's missing a closing parenthesis. Oh, I added an extra if statement in there. I do not want to do that. So backspace all of that out. And now it matches what we had in the average. So click enter there. Same thing. Double click to go all the way down. And if I go back to here, and why don't I just add life expectancy under this again? And it's already doing a sum. So perfect. And that allows you to see that our sum if here in column F matches what we have in column C. I'll click on column D, do a right click insert just so we have some space between the pivot table and our little chart here. Okay, so we should give this some titles. Since we already have them in the pivot table, I'll just select them, do a copy, click cell F3, right click values. Select these two cells and do a double click on the edge. And there we go. Okay, so that was a very quick demo, and those are only two functions that we just learned. There's a whole bunch more, and in the following videos, I'll start to cover some things like if statements and VLOOKUPs, so go ahead and save this and keep following along. See you in the next one.